The PS5 release date is fast approaching, and boy am I ready for it. But what horror games are getting ready too? I don't know, but I can guess. Greetings gamers, and welcome back to Top 10 Gaming. I'm your host, Carmen Rowe, and honestly, I'm hyped for the PS5. Backwards compatibility is what really sold me. Like, that's the one thing that Xbox had, but now PlayStation has it too. But with new consoles comes plenty of spooky games that will need to be re-released, but which ones should be prioritized? That's what we're exploring with today's list of the top 10 scary games we need to see on the PS5. If you're new here or haven't yet, be sure you hit like and subscribe for daily gaming content, and because I make a fool of myself on the regular, and the other hosts are actually good at their jobs. Okay, let's jump in. And at 10, FNAF. The Five Nights at Freddy's series is all too familiar on this channel, and I know for a fact that some of you will be typing right now that FNAF is going to be on the PlayStation 5. I mean every FNAF game, okay, not just the newest one, Security Breach. I don't know if it's been confirmed, but considering how most PlayStation 4 games will be playable on the PlayStation 5, I don't think that there's really any quarrels as to whether they'll be added to the roster. I think that it's inevitable that we end up seeing the other FNAF games, especially when there's a movie on the way, at least at some point. Is that thing even still happening? I don't know. The only update I've seen is that MAPPAT may be working on it. Oh boy. Also, if you love FNAF and want to see the countless hours I spent researching it and then having to put it into lists, click up in the top right corner right now and you can check out our FNAF playlist. And at 9, Amnesia: The Dark Descent. Amnesia: The Dark Descent is one of the most iconic horror games of all time. Being released in 2010, I think this horror classic is due for a remaster. Imagine this game with improved graphics and a new game engine behind it. That would be terrifying. Even if it wasn't in virtual reality, just the sheer thought of the Amnesia series getting a revamp is just bone shaking. And no, I don't mean the Bone Shaker IPA either. That stuff will shake you to your core, but not in a good way. I know that all too well. It's only good from a picture. Anyway, the whole plot of the game is that you wake up in a castle with no memory about yourself. The castle is full of dark and empty halls where you can find clues to your past, like the fact that you erased your own memory in order to save yourself from the trauma of being hunted by a shadow. But then you're still being hunted by that shadow. That hurts, man. Like, imagine you sacrifice your life to save your friends, but then those friends go and get themselves killed 10 minutes after. That's what that feels like. Like, who's your ghost gonna haunt now? Who would you haunt if you were turned into a ghost? Let me know below, because, like, I'm actually kind of curious. It says a lot about someone, about, like, who they'd haunt. I'd probably be so powerful that I'd haunt Satan. yeah. And at 8, Dead Space Remastered. Dead Space is a survival horror game from 2008 by EA, before they only cared about money. This is the first game in the Dead Space series, and honestly, we need a whole series on the PS5, but for now, I'll settle for the first one. This game is also iconic, but also in a different way to Amnesia. This game was so popular and so good, it got itself 2 sequels, countless spin-offs, and even an animated film and comic prequel. Even FNAF hasn't gotten to the comic prequel side of things yet. Getting the entire Dead Space series on the PS5 in a new and remastered way with a new engine and graphics would be both incredible for old fans and potentially new ones of the series. The game was intended to just create a new IP, but the game became praised for its atmosphere, sound design, and gameplay, some aspects that were insane, especially for 2008. The game has sold more than 2 million copies, so there is another reason to remaster it and put it on the PS5. I would 100% play it, and Dead Space 2 and 3. Okay, just give me all the Dead Space, okay? I'll feel at home. And it's 7, Left 4 Dead 2. Left 4 Dead 2 is my favorite zombie survival game, okay? Screw COD Zombies, screw Last of Us, screw Saints and Sinners, screw even Plants vs. Zombies, yeah, I said it. Left 4 Dead 2 is an incredible game, and if you haven't played it, I highly recommend that you get it on Steam, or hopefully, the PS5. I say specifically Left 4 Dead 2 because of the multiplayer mode where you can play as the zombies, you know, versus mode. Watching and playing that was some of the most fun I've had as a kid, and even somewhat recently. I used to get all my friends on this train, okay? My sister, my best friend. That's it. The random kid I met at the park who just kept pulling his pants down, you know? Anyone and everyone I could, I told them to play this game. Most of them didn't, but I still play Left 4 Dead with my sister and Cameron, so there's something about that. There's just something about mowing down countless waves of zombies as a concert is roaring in the background that just does it for me. Especially when you can set a tank that looks like Maui on fire using fireworks from that concert. And don't even get me started on the mods. If I can kill 1,000 zombies that look like Teletubbies or Zoidbergs with the help of mods, I'll freaking do it, man. And the tank mod that makes it look like Maui from Moana, I will never not play with that thing again, okay? Just standing there and hearing "what can I say except you're welcome" will never be more terrifying. And at 6, Blair Witch. The Blair Witch game is set 2 years after the events of the 1999 Blair Witch movie, which was set in 1994, so this game takes place in 1996. The game is focused on survival horror in the best way, prioritizing stealth over just hiding until you can kill the scary thing. The game is also a first-person game, and follows Officer Ellis Lunch as he searches for a missing boy. The game lets you use things like a camera, cell phone, flashlight, and your trusty pal Bullet to follow the trail of the missing 9-year-old. You find some creepy things along the way too, like photographs, wooden dolls, and cassette tapes that are how the game integrates the found footage thing into the game. So yes, all you found footage lovers will still get your fix in this game's storytelling and cutscenes. The game came out in 2019, so it's not really due for a remastering, but I still think the game would do incredibly well with the new DualSense controllers and haptic feedback. You could hear the cracking of the branches and feel where it came from in the game through the controller. Oh, that would be terrifying, but so good. Halfway through at number 5, Slender. There are plenty of Slenderman games, only a couple that have actually been made into full games, like Slender the 8 Pages and Slender the Arrival, for example. Both from the same company, but the Arrival was the one that was officially licensed by the guy who created Slenderman for that Photoshop contest oh so long ago. Like, damn. Slenderman and Siren Head were both created and then blew the hell up. Like, maybe I should make a monster in an effort to become rich and famous and then make that character have a movie. Nah, if I did that, I'd have to pay child support. Haha. Get it? Because children are little monsters? Moving on. A new Slenderman game on the PS5 with the ability to use the haptic feedback inside the cameras, and hell, even just stop at Slender would be good enough for me. I just want scary games to use the new DualSense, okay? Feel the static. Ah, my god, please. In at 4, Sons of the Forest. Sons of the Forest is an up-and-coming sequel to The Forest, one of my favorite games. I love The Forest for just the astounding game design. The sandbox elements combined with the story of trying to find your son after a plane crash onto a cannibal island full of mutants hungry for human flesh. Ah, so good. The Sons of the Forest is a continuation of one of the endings, the ending that actually ends the game instead of the one that lets you keep playing, which makes sense since there's more story with a whole cliffhanger. I'm not gonna spoil it for you in case you haven't played it, but I suggest you do, especially if you want to play Sons of the Forest, or you can also just watch your favorite YouTuber play it. Ooh woo. If he's ever able to play it on the channel, or maybe on my personal one. Am I allowed to say that? Like, I've played it on my own, but I haven't completed it, so honestly, it's kind of pointless. And at 3, PT. Holy crap, you knew PT was going to be on this list, okay? PT is probably one of the best examples of horror games of all time. If you're unaware, PT stands for Playable Teaser, and was a first-person horror game for the reinvigoration of the Silent Hill series, which was planned on being known as Silent Hill. The game was very reminiscent of Layers of Fear, where you go around the same level again and again with slight changes. There's a weird little alien baby in a sink, there's a weird hanging freezer with blood coming out of it, there's a hostile ghost named Lisa who is constantly following you, trying to get you. The game is terrifying, and Lisa is even more terrifying. I have a family friend named Lisa, who like we used to see somewhat often, but like she didn't look like this, but I can't help but think about her and her family when I hear the name Lisa, so this kind of makes it weird for me. I mean, like, it's also kind of scary. I mean, it's odd. Let's say that, it's odd. Also, is this just like a Canadian thing, or do people like have family friends that you call like aunt and uncle outside of our country? Like your parents' friends that you grew up thinking they're family? I hope it's not just me. Oh god, imagine if it was. Haha, that'd be scarier than PT. But not really. Bring it to the PS5, please. And it's Outlast Remastered. Outlast is another horror classic, icon, and titan. Released in 2013, the game has actually appeared on the PS4, Xbox One, and Nintendo Switch, so it's highly likely the game could be brought to the PS5. The thing is, I want a new version. Remastered, revamped, reinvigorated, rehydrated, whatever adjective you want to use, I'm down for it. This is the game that needs the haptic feedback. Are you kidding? In this game, there's no defending yourself. You're just an investigative journalist with a camera, and if you get attacked, you're done for. You're screwed. You're finished. You're f***ed. If I can't defend myself, I'm booking it out of there, okay? That goes against my instincts, but whatever. Plot, right? Either way, being able to hear the little things and feel the room with the haptic feedback and adaptive triggers would just make it incredible and the experience terrifying. Just think about it, okay? You're in a dark hallway with no light. You bring up a camera so you can see, and you see four creatures in front of you. You start walking and they don't notice you. You walk past one, then two, but then you feel the controller shaking, the one behind you just noticed. You can feel where they are. You brown your pants and then start crying because the jump scare was the worst of your life. Boom! Done! You understand now. Finally, in at number one, Phasmophobia. I haven't played Phasmophobia yet. Honestly, I was too scared. Phasmophobia is one of the most iconic horror games right now. I'm not salty. The game is playable both in VR and on flat mode. Basically, this game requires you to find and identify a form of supernatural entity located in a home or a school or farmhouse, you know, something like that. They can range from good old spirits to ghosts to djinn to even demons. And they each have their own evidence and quirks that help you identify them. But they also want to kill you because, like, well, what would a horror game be without someone trying to kill you, right? Come on, think about it. Just don't die. There we have it, friends, the top 10 scary games we need on the PS5. What games do you want to see come to the PS5, and have you played Phasmophobia yet? Let me know down below, and creators of Phasmophobia, I'll be expecting an Instagram message on how I can accept my payment. On your way to yell at me for making a joke that you didn't like, be sure you hit like and subscribe for daily gaming content, as well as Phasmophobia gameplay tomorrow, and ring the bell to join the clan and level up. Thank you all so much for watching. I have been and shall remain Connor Monroe, and I'll see you in another video. All of the apostrophes are question marks. This is annoying. Amnesia series getting a... Dead Space is a survival horror.